Hi, I'm Angela Bishop and welcome to Bish's Biz. She describes herself as an actress, writer, singer, mother, and probably your teenage crush. She's Molly Ringwald and she's gone from teenage star to smoky jazz singer. And she's in Australia for her first tour.
Films brought you here last time, but this time it's two very different things. Tell me.
Well, I came for the Sydney Writers Festival as a writer, and I'm also performing songs off of my new jazz CD, which is called Except Sometimes.
Two very different things indeed. Let's start with the fact that you've released a book. It's a work of fiction. How long have you been an author?
I've been writing pretty much all through my teen years and through my 20s and 30s. But it wasn't until I turned 40 that I started to publish. This is my first work of fiction, which is a little darker and moodier and a little bit more complex.
Moving on to your fantastic jazz album, Except Sometimes. Now, this isn't your first album either, but probably the longest time between albums I've ever heard of.
Yeah, the first album that I did, I was 6 years old. And it was for my father, well, it was with my dad's jazz band, because my father is a traditional jazz musician. So it was something that I did when I was very, very young. But this is, for all intents and purposes, this is my first album.
Tell me about some of the songs you've chosen for.
They're all pretty much from what is known as the Great American Songbook. So they're standards. I have a song that was in Dick Tracy. Sung by,
the
Stephen Sondheim song. It's a beautiful song. And I have one contemporary song, sort of contemporary. It was, it's a jazz version of Don't You Forget About Me, which was kind of the theme from The Breakfast Club.
Don't you forget about me.
When I recorded the album, it wasn't that long after John Hughes had passed away. And I thought it would be really nice to sing something in tribute to him.
Why do you think you two worked so well together?
I don't know. I think we just had a certain connection. I don't know exactly why. We just got along really well. And, we were born on the same day, February 18th, 18 years apart. I don't know. There was just something about it. You know, I felt like I understood what he was trying to do, and I feel like he felt like I was the person who could express what he was trying to express, and so it just worked.
You know, I have just as many feelings as you do, and it hurts just as much when somebody steps all over them.
At the time when you realized, did you realize what an impact those films had on a generation and in subsequent generations, or have you only sort of gained that insight with the passing of the years?
There was no way to anticipate that at the time. I knew I liked the movies. I loved the scripts, and I had a really good time making them, but I think it's only been with the passing of the years that I've realized that they've taken on a sort of, iconic status.
As the mum of a 9-year-old and nearly 4-year-old twins, how old are they going to be when you let them see your films?
Well, I thought that they were going to be teenagers, but it turned out that just about everyone in my elder daughter's class had already seen the movies, and she thought it was very unfair that she hadn't. So I did show her 16 Candles and Pretty in Pink, but she hasn't seen The Breakfast Club yet.
Wait a little more for that.
Yeah.
So you're in town. We have the pleasure of your company for quite some time here in Australia, which is fantastic because you're going to be touring.
Yes.
Tell me what that's going to be like for you. Have you got the family on the road? You've got the gypsy caravan?
Yeah. No, we don't have a gypsy caravan, but I do have, right now I have the twins, and then my husband and elder daughter are coming pretty soon. We're really excited. You know, I've been talking to my family about Australia for years because I've been here quite a few times, but they've never come. So they're all very excited to see kangaroos and koalas and, and it's such a beautiful country. You know, I think we're really going to have a great time. And I'm doing the thing that I love to do the most, which is sing. It's definitely, of all the things that I do, I think that it's the most joyful.
He's one of the biggest movie stars in the world, but he's also a committed family man, which is why Will Smith thinks starring with his son in the movies is the best form of parenting there is. I caught up with Will and son Jaden at the premiere of their new movie After Earth in Taiwan.
In the field, you are emotionally unpredictable. You confuse courage with recklessness. I'm not advancing you.
You have a son that you do not know. He's reaching for you, and he does not need a commanding officer. He needs a father. Now go make some good memories together.
Congratulations on the film. What an amazing ride to go on, but at heart, mm-hmm. a father-son story, yeah. and that was the best bit about it.
Yeah, you know, it was just a great time mm-hmm. Coming together with my son. He was 13 years old when we started shooting, so there's like something mythological about taking your young son at 13, and a lot of the ideas and things that the characters were dealing with in the movie were very similar to some of the things that he and I were dealing with in real life. So,
wow.
Yeah, it was like a cool kind of after-Earth therapy session.
You understand? You are going to retrieve that beacon, or we are going to die. Do you understand? Repeat what I just said to you.
I have to go retrieve the beacon. Or we're going to die.
Just set the scene for us, for those who haven't seen it yet, when it opens in Australia in mm-hmm. June.
So it's after Earth, it's a thousand years in the future.
After humans have been evicted from Earth
for our environmental neglect and
yes.
abuse.
Yes.
So we've had to find a new world, and Earth essentially turned against humankind and is
one of the most hospitable places in the world for
uninhabitable humans. And our characters, General Cypher Rage and his son Katai, crash land back on Earth, and it becomes a survival action adventure.
Brilliant, with a whole lot of very creepy monsters.
We're very, yeah.
Control yourself, cadet.
Tom, stand down.
Get away. Get away.
Guitar.
To your rear. Out to your rear.
There's a river, 250 meters straight ahead. Go.
Do you guys consider yourself lucky to be one of the only ones I can think of in Hollywood who get to work together as father and son like this? It's a fortunate position to be in.
Yeah, it really is. I grew up in my family business. My father owned a business, and all of my brothers and sisters and my mother and cousins and everybody worked in the business. So it's really the only way that I know how to parent.
Oh, right.
Yeah, that you have to be together every day working, and the issues of life present themselves with real life consequences, and you deal with it and you learn and you talk and you grow together. So for me, it's as strange as it may seem for a father and son to be on the poster of a global action adventure film. We're very blessed to be in that position.
Now, with your producer hat on, Will, mm-hmm. you are here in Asia mm-hmm. Doing a lot of promotion for the film. As a producer, this market's just growing and growing yeah. and coming to see movies, aren't
Absolutely.
They?
Absolutely, yeah. You know, the world is really expanding in terms of cinema. You know, for the first time in decades,
yeah.
America isn't the fastest growing movie market in the world, and there are multiple markets that have leapfrogged over America. So for me as a producer and as a fan of movies, it's exciting to go to places where people just have a ferocious appetite for cinema.
So, Jaden, you never considered being an accountant or anything?
No, I didn't.
What'd you want? Willow wanted to be a fireman.
Willow wanted to be a baseball player.
A baseball player.
Yes. That's right.
Did you have any input on your great costumes in the film?
No, I didn't.
Yeah.
That was before I was into the clothes.
I was dictating a little
yeah,
bit.
Yeah, he was.
But I was asking your opinion. Did you like it?
we had different things where I was like, no, I don't think we should do that. I don't think we should do that. And then we came across the life suit, and I was like, yeah.
We must abort this mission.
You wouldn't give any other ranger that order.
You are not a ranger. You are my son.
Remember, danger is very real. But fear is a choice. If we are going to survive this, we fight.
That's all for now. See you next time.